Hi, this is David at How Now Video, and today I'm going to be talking about how to shoot with two cameras, shooting a play or a concert where you're under stage lighting and you want to prevent overexposing, especially people's faces. Now, with these two cameras, they're both Panasonics. This one on the right here is the HMC150, and this would be my primary camera where I would zoom in and follow the action a little closer. And my second camera is the TM700 by Panasonic, which represents my wide shot. Now, the small camera, typically you would set the aperture and forget it. So there's a technique of a way to set this up so that you will not get any overexposing. Now, the HMC150, on the other hand, allows you to set the aperture and use something called zebra striping to show you when you are overexposing, especially the faces. So let me show you how these two cameras are set up for shooting dramas, stage performances like concerts or plays. Okay, let us start with the HMC150. And if you look closely here, you'll see that I have zebra striping enabled. Now I can turn it off. There's a button on the side here. And without it turned on, you will not be aware that you are overexposing the whites. But if I put it back on to the 75% setting, the lines show up. Now these lines will not be recorded onto videotape, but they do warn you that your shot is too hot. Now if I get in front of this camera, you'll see that my face is overexposed. Now this is much too hot. If you shot a play or a stage show like this, your skin tones would be overexposed. So if I take the aperture down to 4.0 f-stop in these lighting conditions, it'll fix the problem. So I will change the aperture here to about 4.0. And you'll still see some zebra striping on here, but my face tones are much, much better. So if a person's wearing a white shirt, for example, you can allow the white shirt to still have zebra stripes, but do not let the faces have zebra stripes because that would be overexposed. Now the way to set up your camera is to go into the menu, go to Display Setup, and you can see the settings here. You're able to dial in where you want the zebra striping to show up. And there are many options here. You would think 100% might be good, but in fact, I found that 75% is best to prevent faces from overexposing. All right, on my second camera, which is the TM700, you would use a different technique because typically you're not going to be controlling the second camera. You're just going to be letting it run. So what I do is I go into the menu before we start, and I click here to go into the menu and go to Record Setup, Scene Mode, and choose this stage lighting setting. Now, I also go down to the other setting called Picture Adjust, and I also set that exposure to be -5 and hit Enter. Now, this will guarantee that your shots will not be overexposed, even if it's a shot where the person is right under a spotlight. And that's a way to set up your secondary camera so that it will perfectly shoot under bright lights. So now if I get in front of this camera, you'll see how it works. You can see that that automatic setting will prevent overexposure. So that's a quick introduction on how to set up two cameras to shoot under stage lighting. Now, stage lighting is typically 3200K, meaning the light temperature is 3200 Kelvin. Now the HMC150 has a setting for 3200. Now the little camera also has some settings. You can get very close to the 3200. Or you can take your camera under certain lighting conditions and shoot it against a white card so that both your cameras will look identical. Okay, so here we are in Premiere Pro CS5. And I want to show you some footage I shot recently of A Christmas Carol. And this is an example. If I hit the tilde key and I'll hit play.
See you all back. What I'd love for you to do right now is turn off any pagers, telephones.
All right, so this is an example where I did not let her skin tone go beyond the 75%. Because faces are very susceptible to overexposing. If I hit the tilde key to get out of that, I can show you different scenes. Now, again, I hit the tilde key, and you'll see that the whites in the shirt are overexposing because we are losing some detail, and that will happen sometimes, but the faces are not overexposing. So that is an example of how to use the technique I showed you. Now I'm going to turn on the wide shot. And again, using the technique of putting the small camera on stage lighting and bringing the exposure down to -5 will prevent whites from overexposing. So that's a real life situation where I use that technique. So thanks again for watching hownowvideo.com. And don't forget to order my 5-hour DVD training video. I've sold over 200 of these worldwide in the last year alone. And we'll see you soon.